to show you how to put the machinery into your body, and I'm going to show you where you get the machinery from. So the first thing that, things that you're going to want are the cyberware scanner, and most likely, and probably the cyberware engineering table. The scanner is crafted with a cyber eye or salvaged cyber eyes, a diamond, and a bunch of iron ingots. This will scan your cyberware and get it in the salvaged cyberware, and will pretty much give you the usable copy, but it takes Minecraft days, hours in real life. The engineering table is a piston, a crafting table, and a bunch of iron ingots like that. And this has a chance to give you the cyberware blueprints, and then you have to make it. You put the cyberware there, you get all the parts, then get the and a blueprint in there, put the blueprint there, and then you can make it. You have a 15% chance that you'll actually get it. And this right here is used to charge your cyberware. And I'm pretty sure that has to be hooked up to a redstone block. This is pretty much, you can hold all your blueprints here, or, a bunch of stuff, how you don't have, chests full of them, and you can make it look all professional, I guess. And there's a component box where it stores all the parts. I'm pretty sure there's only this many parts that overall, I'm pretty sure. So, I'm pretty sure that works out perfectly. You might need one or two, but, yeah, it works. So, next we have to go into survival mode, and oh man, I didn't know my health was so low when I started this, but then I'm gonna grab all this armor, and sword, shield, and we're gonna go fight some cyber zombies, which are in here, and pretty much this is how you get all the cyberware. Get one before they all burn to death or kill me. Oh, see, I got a piece of machinery. See how they cyber zombies, even if they burn to death, they drop a piece of machinery. And there goes all my stuff. So I'm pretty sure I lost my cyber eyes during that, and all my stuff. Yep. Okay. But go hit some, attack some villagers or something. Go ahead and please die. Oh no! 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 Why is it this happens? Come on! This always happens when I jump over the chest. You won't be able to get me. Minecraft 101. Maybe zombies can fit in between chests and fences. I'm pretty sure a lot of things can. But anyway, I'm going to put back on this armor, and I'm actually going to keep it on because honestly, I look pretty good in this. But, so yeah, as you can see, I had all of that stuff in. I'm going to have to put that back in. And this is actually a perfect time to actually show you how to do that. But first, I'm going to show you some things with the salvage stuff. So this works for everything salvaged. Put that in there. And, I was lucky to get a blueprint. That's pretty much how that works. And this, I don't expect to get anything from that even at the end. But we'll check on that, I guess, at the end a little bit. And there's actually things you can do to make spawners, and there's a radio kit and a radio beacon. The kit is made of fiber optics, iron ingots, and solid state circuitry. The radio beacon is made with iron ingots and iron vendor. The radio kit, solid state circuitry, and two titanium mesh, which I put some over there in hopes that some stuff will spawn in there. production, but what you want is some way to store that power. So, then you step in here, close the door, and I just realized I never showed you exactly what these were. So, this is the herb resurgent. There's no crafting recipe, you have to find it in dungeon chests. And this is an iron door, block of iron, and a bunch of iron. You get, so you have to be very ironful, or have a lot of iron. So, there's a bunch of stuff. Now, first, I'm going to show you, I'm going to put in a cyber arm. Now, I've got things, you can put in more than one. I'm actually going to put in the left one so you can see it on the screen, because I use my left hand. Death message. You didn't return from the operation. So, which is why I guess that's why you're supposed to have a lot of health on you. But I'm actually gonna put in the right cyber arm, that way it doesn't glitch out a lot. And I need to make sure I have that. And I'm actually gonna show you what synthetic skin does as well. It actually hides the cyberware, so if, you know, you don't want people to know, like, let's say you have the, like, the Wolverine claw thing. I'm pretty sure I already have to put that in. No? Where'd it go? I lost it, but it pretty much just did extra damage with punches. Nothing I could really show too much of, so I'm actually gonna take that arm out. This chest over here, everything I've already done, I don't need the arms. So then, now I'm pretty sure I can put this in. It just kind of gives you increased health, okay, yeah. Evidently, you can't. Yeah, I forgot about that when I made this initially, forever ago. But now, I'm going to put in myself two cyber legs, and these things, where, okay, you can only have one. But allows you to jump higher, and I think that would be really cool. Now, tolerance honestly, I've actually never seen that before. Let me just will it cause them not to work properly? I cannot get me out into the sun so I can get this to work. So yeah, now you can see, but I can't see. I put on, see the cyber, how with the cyber arm it showed. Apparently that is what will cause rejection, means it will try and kick it out of your body. So I will show you, that is cool. And yeah, you kind of have to be careful. I actually made a parkour course around this, so I'm just going to put everything away that I'm not going to. Not gonna use a synthetic skin. And it says jump more powerful with two cyber legs, but I also want to be able to show you on the eyes. So I'm doing this all over again, so that way you guys pretty much, there's no chance that you missed what or how to do this. After this, I'm pretty much just gonna show you how both of them work, and this is the first time where, now nothing doesn't work. Need my food, actually. Give me that. So now, we need to, wait a little bit, because the, as you can see, I do jump higher, and if I shift jump, it is absolutely amazing. Hold on. And boom. See, you saw, guys saw. What did I guess? Am I in a tree now? I feel like I'm in a tree. No, I was in the pole. Well, yeah, so these are pretty dangerous, but again, it's pretty cool how you just leap around. And so, you know what? I'll just leap over to the button. I have a button. Oh, wait. Boom, jump on tree. Boom, tree jump. Whatever, but jumping regularly is now enough, I'm pretty sure. Boom, yeah, you can jump right over fences. Hey guys, so I'm gonna quickly show you this. I don't want this video to be too long, but in this command block, it will give me blindness. And as you saw, it sort of happened, then it went away because of the cyber eyes. On the mini app, there's nothing really in there. I can see that. But let's just see if this is ready yet. No, it's not. So, as you'll see, this takes absolutely forever. But, guys,